A 12-year-old male has a growth on his lower lip. It's been there over 2 months and his parents are concerned. What is this and how do we treat it? The full case today on The Open Reduction. Welcome to The Open Reduction, your channel covering all topics oral and maxillofacial surgery. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten, and today we're talking about an interesting pathology case. This patient is a 12-year-old male who developed a growth on his lower lip over 2 months ago. He doesn't remember any traumatic event or anything else that could have caused this lesion. It doesn't hurt, but it's not going away. It's a cosmetic concern, and his parents are getting worried. He is an otherwise healthy child with no history of similar growths. First, let's describe this lesion. It's located on the vermilion of the right lower lip and measures about 4 millimeters in diameter. It is a solitary lesion and it appears friable. It's a red pedunculated papule. The adjacent mucosa appears healthy and there's no induration. He has no neck lymphadenopathy and his exam is otherwise unremarkable. Now that we've completed our physical exam, we need to put together a differential diagnosis. This lesion does not have the physical findings consistent with a malignant growth, so it's most likely a benign lesion. It could be arising from the epithelium of the lip, but it could be from other tissue in the area, like vascular tissue, neural tissue, or muscle. This has the clinical appearance of a hemangioma, a benign vascular tumor. Another potential vascular lesion is a pyogenic granuloma. This could also be a skin lesion, like a nevus. This could also certainly be viral in origin. It has the appearance of verruca vulgaris, or a wart. Now that we have a solid differential diagnosis, it's time to decide what to do. Our differential is full of benign lesions, but this is in a highly visible area. No one wants this growing on their lip, so monitoring is not an option. All of these lesions on our differential are treated with local excision, so that's what we decided to do. I removed this lesion using an elliptical excisional technique. This growth was close to the vermilion border, so the border was violated. The key to closing this incision is to reapproximate the vermilion border so there's no cosmetic defect. The tissue is then sent to the pathologist for a definitive diagnosis. The pathology report came back as a pyogenic granuloma. A pyogenic granuloma is technically a lobular capillary hemangioma. The exact cause of these lesions is unknown. Certain medications and dermatologic conditions are associated with an increased risk. Pyogenic granulomas also have the common name of a pregnancy tumor because they are sometimes seen in the gingiva of pregnant women, suggesting a hormonal component. They tend to resolve after pregnancy, but obviously this patient isn't pregnant, and pyogenic granulomas not associated with pregnancy don't resolve on their own. Treatment options include shave excision or laser ablation, but the treatment with the lowest risk of recurrence is local excision, which is what I did in this case. There is still a low chance this lesion will recur, in which case another excision will be necessary. Thanks so much for watching. Please click those like and subscribe buttons and keep an eye on my website, theopenreduction.com, for advanced surgical techniques. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten. I'll catch you next time on The Open Reduction.